Hi, I'm Catherine Ann Davies, otherwise known as the Anchoress, and I've just won the Best Newcomer, the Limelight Award at the Prog Awards. It's just amazing. I mean, this is my first album. It just came out at the beginning of the year, and it's just, I never expected that the album would do this well and get any kind of recognition whatsoever. Every single thing that's happened this year has just been like, is this really happening? Like getting to be on stage with the Manics, winning this award. So many things have happened that you just, I don't know, it's just all overwhelming really at the moment. Probably need a drink.
Of course, we're here tonight at the Progressive Music Awards. What for you is the true spirit of progressive music?
I think probably the key for me is in the name itself, the idea of something constantly evolving, constantly progressing, kind of pushing at the vanguard. And I think that the true spirit of prog in the 21st century would be about shifting forwards and maybe thinking about kind of reaching out into other genres and not maybe just drawing upon the traditional sort of prog elements that you might think of, you know, the concept record, the extended solo, the virtuosity. But perhaps I think what I'd like to do is kind of push it a little bit more into the mainstream as well.
What was it like working with the Manics, being on stage with them?
It was just amazing. There are no words for it. It was the absolute single best moment of my life. I mean, I've been a huge fan of them as a kid, and just to be asked to support them, and let alone then to be asked to duet with them on stage, was just amazing. It was just something I'll remember the rest of my life. I think the thing about the Manics is that they're a band that changed people's lives. I mean, not many rock and roll bands can kind of lay claim to having a lasting impact upon people's lives beyond being your first crush, or maybe, you know, a band you kind of remember going to their gig or something like that. I think the Manics have had a really lasting kind of cultural impact on a lot of their fans. You know, they've made kids who perhaps from poor backgrounds who wouldn't have gone to university go to uni, people write books, read books that they wouldn't have read, just open their and expand their horizons really. And I think, you know, what more can you ask from a rock and roll band than that really?
What are you moving on to next?
Well, at the moment I'm in the middle of recording Paul Draper's solo records. I've written half of that record with him, so I'm really busy recording that, taking a little bit of time out. That's what I call a holiday. And I started work on the second record, and I'm also in the middle of a collaborative project with Bernard Butler as well, so very busy.
Fans have their favourite tracks. Is there one in particular that's the most special to you, the most precious?
I really enjoy singing P.S. You live, as you can imagine.
For anyone who's not familiar, can you give us a little explanation of the original inspiration for that particular piece of musical genius?
I think it might be a little bit libelous if I was to actually name the inspiration for that track. I think it can mean whatever it wants to whoever's listening to it.
Progressive Music Awards 2016 anthem, Riverside Towards the Blue Horizon. I think this is a song. Well, I have to say that this is kind of a personal song, and I wrote this song for a friend who passed away at the age of 43, 44, 2 years ago. And I wrote this song for him, but all these circumstances that happened this year, you know, made that lots of people started to quote this song as some other references. And which I think that this, because of this, this song now has a totally different meaning for us. It's very, very personal. So this reward is also very personal for us and has a lot of meaning.
What's the true spirit of progressive music, do you think?
Originality. I think that's something that comes from your heart, mostly. You know, I think that it's always nice when your inspiration comes from something that you feel, not what you hear or, I don't know, listen to. So talking about the music, everything that is connected with something else than music, it's much more original, and for me, it's my bigger influence for sure. We had the pleasure to sit right next to, you know, the members of the Yes band, Genesis and stuff, so this is something that we grew up on, and this is a very nice experience for us, for sure. We need to carry on with a different lineup, and this different lineup will be only three of us. This is the new lineup, because we will stay as a trio, and probably we will work with our friends, different guitar players, but we will choose the, you know, more Genesis path more than some other casting band. path, and probably that will be the new beginning for us, you know. And we are trying to, this year we are releasing our new album, the instrumental one, ambient one, which I hope shows that we are not only progressive metal band, but we have also something more to say in the wider genre. And next year we will start to do something new for sure.
How important do you think that is as a band to continue to evolve and to constantly be in motion in that sense?
It's very important. It's very important. It's the truth, and it's the main core of being a musician, being an artist. So we still want to develop ourselves. We still want to carry on. As soon, you know, as much as we have something to say, I would love to continue this for sure.
You have a message to your fans out there, and I guess particularly all the people for whom this track has had such a poignant significance.
We would like to thank you for the support, first and foremost, because this is very important stuff. And and say thank you. Yeah, we would like to thank you.
Well, we are I'm the Morning. We're from Russia, and we just got album of the year, Lighthouse. So that's it, basically.
What does this particular honor mean to you tonight?
Well, this is kind of a confirmation that we didn't just waste many months of our lives working on this album, because it was like a very tough experience and we worked very, very hard. And the subject that we built the concept of the album around is very heavy. So it's really lovely that people are accepting and that we got this award. So yeah, it's such a stunning experience. We never expected anything like that, so I'm a bit lost for words. Okay, so it's a tough subject, because the concept is built around the subject of mental illness and the progression of the mental illness inside someone else's mind. So it was inspired by works of Virginia Woolf and Sylvia Plath. And basically, I wanted to speak up about that, because I know that a lot of people have difficulties about talking about this. And this is really sad, because people that face those sort of issues, they really need help, and they need to know that they are not alone in that. They have someone to talk to about that someone feels the same way. And partly it was inspired by my own experience when I was like still a teenager even. I've been listening to bands like Anathema, for example, and their music really helped me through some very complicated periods. And so I wanted our music to be a great companion to other people, and to kind of keep them company, to let them know that they're not alone. I've met a lot of people from kind of our fan base that sent me some really touching messages about how this music, basically they said that it saved their lives and they helped them through very dark times in their lives. And also it's really pleasant for me to hear that what we do inspires other people, because we received a lot of messages about how we inspired someone to do music, or kind of be particularly attentive towards what they are doing and trying to become better. So if we inspire other people to do something that inspire other people to do something that inspire other people, well, that's what it is about. It's a very beautiful protest that I think will eventually lead to something really beautiful.
What for you is the true spirit, the essence of progressive music?
Never being still, always moving forward, and always growing. So that's basically it.
Of course, there's a wonderful lineup of legends from the genre here tonight. Is there anyone you're especially excited to meet or be rubbing shoulders with tonight?
A lot of people, actually. I'm very excited to meet a lot of people, but it's been particularly lovely to meet up with my friends with Mute Gods and Riverside, and meet people from Aurelian or Big Big Train and Knife World. It's just like basically a room packed with amazingly talented people, so it's been a great pleasure to be here. Well, Gleb is working on his solo album, and I think that I'm the Morning will do the next one next year. At least I hope so. So our thoughts will soon be entirely dedicated to this next big, beautiful something. it's been amazing. It's been an amazing journey, and we are really happy to share it with all of you. And if at some point you feel sad, you know, you should know that you're not alone. Yeah, and there is always someone out there who feels like this, and there is always hope and there is always light.
Anthony Phillips, and I've been very lucky somehow to win the Grand Design Award. So this is for the reissues series, which Esoteric have put out of my first five albums.
What does this particular honour tonight mean to you?
It means a hell of a lot, because obviously, the company in which I kept, I mean, I was taken by surprise, because there were some huge artists who I've somehow managed to pivot the post. So I think maybe there needs to be a recount. The artwork was, the remixing was all fantastic, but still it means people aren't going to buy this just because it looks nice. Obviously people must have thought they wanted to get these albums and get them again, so I'm so delighted, and I really can't believe it, actually, the truth of it. Yeah, very chuffed, and very chuffed for all involved.
Of course, we're at the Progressive Music Awards tonight. What for you is the true spirit, the essence of progressive music?
Well, I think there are traps with it, you know, which is it can be overblown. I think that what progressive music did at its best was to just broaden the format of music, you know, where you were just kind of trapped in verse chorus. You could argue the Beatles were starting to be progressive with the track That Day in the Life, which had a lot of different sections, and it, you know. And so I think it was the form of prog which was the main thing. Elasticating the format of music and showing that you can have a long piece with lots of different sections that still has form. It's a bit like, you know, the difference between a short story and a long novel. I mean, you can have a long piece of music that still works. Classical pieces are like that. And I think that what prog tried to do a lot of the time was to have a longer design, so you'd have a more fulfilling listen, maybe not as catchy a listen, but a more fulfilling listen, more colour, more light and shade, more dynamics, you know, perhaps more of a theatrical experience as well. And it got overblown sometimes, and I think people overreached themselves and it got a bit pompous, and that maybe put people off. But at its best, I think it was a really creative force. Well, I would hope that the younger bands just carry on from the Genesis's Yes, King Crimson, and just keep experimenting with longer. There's nothing wrong with verse chorus pop songs, don't get me wrong, you know, I love some. But there's nothing wrong also with experimenting with different forms, maybe something that lasts 4 or 5 minutes. And I just hope people carry on experimenting in a slightly more adventurous format, if you like, you know, ungoverned by the diktats of having to, you know, be played on the radio in 2 minutes kind of thing. I'm very proud of the 5.1 surround sound remixes, because I think particularly on instrumentals, I think it really does change things. Songs you can't do so much with, but you know, if you think of when you're watching a film in the cinema with the surround sound all around you, what a much more complete experience it is. The ability with instrumentals to be able to create a complete sound canvas like that. It's lovely. Yeah, so I would be very proud of those.
Well, I'm Nick Beggs, and this is the excellent Roger King.
I am Roger King, and this is the excellent Nick Beggs. We have just won the Vanguard Award. Is that correct?
That is. Look, it says it here. The Vanguard Award. And we're rather happy. We are the Mute Gods. Well, there's a couple of others. One other, Marco Miniman, and he's also made a fantastic contribution to this record. And we're very grateful. Notoriety by a fan base, which I didn't think we had.
Notoriety is a negative idea,
is it?
Nick, isn't it?
Maybe you
but
could explain
what
that
it means
to me.
Is fame. Well, who knows? Maybe more record sales. But it's very nice to get a pat on the back from people who know what you're doing. It's genuinely a nice thing.
Yes.
A proper pat on the back from people who properly understand that you're doing something that isn't necessarily easy.
Roger, I love you. Marry me now and let's run away from all this.
I'm already pregnant.
What for you is the true essence, the spirit of progressive music?
It's original thought. It's wanting to take chances. There's, of course, there's the cliches can be symphonic or jazz, but I think it's something to do with an experimental mind, really.
It's the absence of boundaries. That's essentially what it is. Do what the you want, and don't worry about whether you're catering to a market. That's what it really means. The constrictions of pop music or cliched rock music, you're not bound by them. So do what you want. If people want to buy it, great. And then when we turn up to something like this and somebody says, we love what you do, it's a lovely pat on the back.
Do it your way. Find your originality. Strive for that originality and write songs that come from a central place, a real place inside you, so people can connect with them.
Difficult album too. Difficult album too, which is in process and being bloody difficult.
What specifically is inspiring that at the moment?
Yeah. Well, we do this because we love it. So we're making music that we want to make. That's the inspiration. We can make money other ways, to be honest. So we do this because we love it. If people like it, then great. They do. It seems they like it. It seems they like
it
what they do.
It would seem so.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. We didn't really expect to win this, but it's a wonderful surprise, and you have given us great faith in ourselves, and we won't let you down. Here's to the next one.
Okay, we are Big Big Train. I'm David Longdon, and this is a Progressive Rock Award for the Band of the Year. Well, it's been voted for by fans and people that like our music. Both our awards have been voted for in that capacity. So it shows our place, if you like, in the affection of people that buy this type of music. And we're honoured. We're absolutely blown away. So thank you for those who voted for us. We're, you know, well, I'm speaking, but speechless, if that makes sense. That kind of thing. Yeah, it's amazing. Thank you.
We make the music for the love of the music. You know, we're not trying to... Just making the music from the heart, and writing songs that move us, and luckily for us, our music is touching other people as well.
Of course, here tonight in the room are some of the absolute icons of the genre. Are there particular people that you're especially excited to see tonight and that have inspired you?
Well, all of them, really. It was fun to hang out. I got to hang out and just chat with Steve Hackett for quite a long time, and hey, how you doing, shake his hands, and just kind of, you know, chit-chat for a while, which is really cool to me. I've been listening to him since I was a young kid, and that was a lot of fun.
Is there any other particular highlights, things that really meant a lot to you in terms of all the wonderful things you've done and achieved?
Well, meeting each other for the first time, yes, having actually sort of been working on records together and not seeing each other at all during the process. All the time we've spent together, and just even times in the recording studio when you're working on people's music and you just get that moment when you think, wow, I'm really into this. And then when you see that sort of transform into what you've done, you know, in the studio, going and meeting the people that, like at the album launch, and then, you know, receiving that, and you just get quite emotional, actually, that all these people really feel that connection as well with the music. So.
Sure. I think at different times, different songs mean different things to different people, don't they? So, you know, we know fans have particular favourites, but I think, you know, we stand by all that we do. And, you know, as Nick said, we just try to do the best that we can.
We've been working on a new album which will be called Grimm's Pound. And it was started off as an EP, and then it kind of got legs, and it's become a fully developed album in its own right. That'll be out next April, I was thinking, yeah. And we've also got some live shows planned around next September, so we'll be hopefully coming after this one again. The new album. Oh, okay. Well, it follows on. It's following on in the tradition of folklore. So it's concluding the songs that have been writing around those themes. Because we want to put a full stop at the end of those types of songs. We're ready to do other things. It's going to be quite a big full stop by the look of it in terms of what we've been writing. But that's what it is. We've written a thing called like the Albion Cycle, which is a series of albums about songs about England and predominantly about England. And that's kind of, the album cycle's coming to the end with Grimm's Pound. And after that, we're on to new things.
Just a really fun time, lots of energy and emotion, and just a really, well, hopefully a great musical experience for them coming to see the show. You know, it's visual, it's auditory, they get to both sides of the coin. Lots of musicians on stage, very full sound. It's a good time.
We don't get these sorts of things without you. These are voted for by you, and we really appreciate the time that you've taken to do it. We really appreciate the fact you take the music that we do and cherish it and allow it into your lives, and thank you.
My name is Jacko Jackchick. I play for King Crimson, and I have just won the 2016 Virtuoso Award.
What does this honour tonight mean for you?
It's an extraordinary thing, you know. I saw King Crimson when I was a kid, and I ended up in the band, and now I've won an award for being in that band. It's an extraordinary thing. I don't know what to say. I'm thrilled.
Of course, we're here tonight at the Progressive Music Awards. What for you is the true spirit, the essence of progressive music?
Well, for me, it's just not being restricted by the confines of traditional song forms, I guess, which means that progressive can mean any number of things. It wasn't called progressive when I was a kid. It was called underground. And I guess we were all just trying to stretch the form and make it go in other places. So to lump everything together under one banner is a bit of a misnomer, I think. The very first time we played was very emotional, you know, because I, you know, it's like any of us, you know, we are grown adults doing what we do, but there's a kind of 12-year-old boy inside of me that's going, I can't believe you're doing this, you know. And the very first time we played was very emotional, you know, because those two things collided. It was an extraordinary thing. It's Robert Fripp. It's Robert Fripp. It's Robert Fripp's vision. It's Robert Fripp's musical angle and take on the world, you know. He's always one step ahead. He's always... He doesn't follow any kind of trend. He does what he does. And this particular lineup, the Crimson, is his vision. And it's an extraordinary thing.
You've just been finishing off rehearsals today. Can you tell us how that's been going and what we can look forward to coming up?
Yeah, it's good. We've last rehearsal today. We've got a couple of warm-up shows and the tour starts on Sunday. We have a new member, and he's great. Great drummer, Jeremy Stacey. And we're off on tour till the end of the year, and we're working again next year. We're kind of committed for the next few years, one way or the other.
I mean, the live shows are fantastic. The question fans always have is, will there be more studio material? Is there any update on that?
Well, not really. Today sees the release of a thing called Radical Action, which is a big box set, which has got two DVDs, three CDs and a Blu-ray. It's everything we played live on the road last year. It's about 3 hours long. And there's new material on that as well. And we are continuing to write new material. Whether that ends up on a studio album, I don't know, I'm not in charge of that, but we're going to still keep writing new stuff and mixing it with archive stuff that the band hasn't played in decades.
Do you have a message to the fans out there that continue to love and support you on that journey?
I'm not sure there are many people out there supporting me on that journey, but for those of them that are, bless you, thank you very much. I'm in a very privileged position and I'm well aware of it, and I'm very grateful.